It could hardly have been a better half for Leeds United, thanks to some pretty ghastly goalkeeping from Pivotal. Tony Yeboah took advantage. He wrapped in his fifth goal of the season in only the third minute, since when Monaco have been very much on the back foot. And despite having plenty of the ball, Lukic hasn't made a single save, really. It's Monaco 0, Leeds 1 at half-time. Substitutions for the second half. Paul Beasley, signed from Sheffield United at the start of this season, makes his European debut for Leeds in place of Tony DiRigo, and Fabian Pivoto has been replaced in goal by Marc Delaroche for Monaco, and I can't say I'm surprised. So Leeds get us away for the second half. They're in the perfect position. They've 45 minutes hard work to come. Present of the ball to Dean, who hammers it across, but the ball was just given to him by Thuram. And a nervous start to the second half by Monaco, just as they made an edgy start to the first. Bully straight away confronted by McAllister. The ball is with Dos Santos. Young wide player, Schifo, the elder statesman of the side. And the ball was played right to the foot of Brian Dean, and again a free kick is awarded against Yeboah. Does have a habit of trying to turn the opponent, so conceding possession back to Monaco. Schifo aims his pass to Anderson. Now Dzumeko, he'll drive one in, and Lukic spills it, but the response from Rea not quite quick enough to take advantage. What a disconcerting moment for John Lukic. There's plenty of pace and spin on that ball from Dzumeko. Many of the Leeds supporters who arrived here today were astonished to find that they could buy tickets. In fact, there were directions around the ground for them telling them where to go. Leeds United supporters, buy your tickets here. And they've been buying tickets at about £6 a time. Seems very cheap. Here come Monaco, and this is a menace to the Leeds net now. Brilliant run! And so unlucky. Anderson, a walk lift of the Brazilian at his best. No wonder the coach can't believe his eyes. The face of Anderson was terrifying there to the Leeds defence. And he curses his luck. Weatherall was all over him. He got away from Dean. On he goes. There were three, four defenders around him. Tenacity, rasping shot, no reward. And Yeboah tries to slip his markers again, and the ball may still come to him. He'll keep up the chase, and he'll win a throw-in. Well, he's got little support up there at the moment, Tony Yeboah. But he knows his role. He did it well. On he goes, curls one in! Fantastic! What a man he is! There can't be many better goal scorers than this fellow anywhere in the world. And even the Monaco supporters rise in applause. Can do no more than pick the ball out of the net. It was a mere half chance. Yeboah takes it with some aplomb. Wonderful strike from Tony Yeboah, and his rich vein just goes on and on. From a glimmer of a hope, gives Leeds a priceless advantage. The Ghanaian is turning into a golden signing for Leeds United. And the chant is Ua Yeboah. They love him. And if Monaco had problems 2 or 3 minutes ago, they have been multiplied. Schieffer tries to get Anderson through. Weatherall again. Said that Weatherall was a contender for man of the match, and so he is. obviously, so is Yeboah, and Ray gets through, and brave keeping from Lukic. Christopher Ray into the Leeds penalty area, right into the heart of it. Kelly, Weatherall coming across, the ball just spun away from Ray. Lukic held on. It was that surge at the end of last season that won Leeds a place in Europe. They were unbeaten in their last 9 matches. Weren't beaten this season until going to White Hart Lane on Saturday, so their form has been outstanding. But Hal Wilkinson said yesterday that the newcomers to Europe tonight would be wide-eyed, he said. But what a wonderful place to play your first European Cup tie in Monte Carlo. You shouldn't be dallying with Yeboah around. Here is the new man. He's found Schipo straight away. Useful looking ball from him. It comes off Weatherall. And if they're going to miss chances like that, they're not going to score tonight. Anderson cannot believe he's not scored. He's just got under the shot, as we'll see on the replay, I'm sure. Again, an element of fortune about the way he was presented the chance. Weatherall's header came back to him off Pemberton. Lukic, to his credit, was off the line quickly and may just have got his fingertips to that shot. Perhaps it should have been a corner. Whatever, it's a let-off. And Leeds still have that priceless two-goal advantage. They wouldn't like it cutting now, even though 2-1 would be an outstanding result. 15 minutes to go, Monaco 0, Leeds 2. Schipo in space, which was afforded him by Leeds. They moved away from him there. Schipo's going to be up around the edge of that penalty area once more. On he goes. Too many Leedsmen around. And it's McAllister. The legs pumping, he drives Leeds forward. Yeboah now. And he's found McAllister again. And offside just given, very late decision by the linesman. And he was offside, Whelan. Di Meco. Dos Santos to do the running and a good push by Gary Kelly. Not a foul one, a goal kick's given. You can see a few empty seats. Leeds have been well represented tonight. They've made a lot of noise. They've silenced the Monaco crowd at times. They've liked what they've seen. Speed is a great jumper. And Yeboah might be in for his third. The goalkeeper comes and Yeboah, he gets his hat-trick. He's in like a flash. Give him a sniff of a goal and he'll say thank you very much. And how they love their new hero, Tony Yeboah. The goalkeeper is so disconsolate. He stays down, he's hurt as well. And it's been a calamitous night for the Monaco defence. Punished clinically by Tony Yeboah. A hat-trick for him, and Leeds are surely on their way through, even at this early stage of the tie. Bully and Delaroche simply got in each other's way. And there is nobody better equipped in the world game to take advantage of that sort of error than Tony Yeboah. Well, it's a sickening sight. Well, there's movement there with Delaroche. But the injury to Basil Bully looks a critical one. He's clinging onto an arm. Well, it's always disconcerting for any player to have to come on in circumstances like this. And it looks as though Claude Puel, the most experienced player in the Monaco side, he's been with the club for 20 years, is going to go in goal for the closing minutes of this game. And sympathetic applause from both Leeds and Monaco fans. Well, it's been a splendid return to UEFA Cup action for Leeds United, and this man, Tony Yeboah, is going to write his name into Leeds United history. A hat-trick tonight, his second for the club, his first in Europe for them, has totally destroyed Monaco's hopes. And the third goal poached when there was a collision between Basil Boley and substitute goalkeeper Marc Delaroche, which sees both of them taken to hospital. It means that the night ends on a rather sad note. It's Monaco 0, Leeds United 3.
3-0 was probably beyond your wildest expectations, but in a way, when you go back to Elland Road, the job still has to be completed.
Oh, we came away from Stuttgart 3-0 down and produced a 4-1 result at home in the second leg. So it's a great result for us, a great result, but only half-time.
I think they'll get through there, don't you?
I thought they were fantastic, Boris. Yeah. It's one of the best performances I've seen away from home by an English side in Europe.
It was. It was a truly unexpected, really, but it was a wonderful result for them.
It was. They really stuck together as a unit, and they worked very, very hard and showed a lot of composure when they had to.
It was a fine overall team performance by Leeds, but really, there's only one man who's starring at the end of it.
I think we saw every aspect of Yeboah's game. We saw the finesse. Here's a terrible mix-up between Pivotal and Turam. And as it drops, a touch of finesse. He knows there's no one in the goal, doesn't panic, just lifts it over the top and it's in the back of the net.
This
is the power ball. Look at him hold off Dimeco. And he gives it one hell of a thump. And Delaroche, that was the first time he'd actually touched the ball in the second half.
It is his power and pace, isn't it? I mean, it's shown in the third one particularly, the pace and then the power. He's holding off, really, the challenge of Basil Boley as well.
That's right. And Boley's he's no slouch either. Look at the pace he shows there. And just ticks out a toe. And it's through between the goalkeeper and Basil Boley.
Of course, in scoring that goal, Ray, there was this dreadful collision, wasn't there?
Absolutely. You know, it's dreadful to see incidents like this anywhere, but on a football field, I think you see Boley there, he's out as soon as their heads make contact, and it really was a sickening sight for a good couple of minutes.
Yes, just to tell everybody at home that the latest news really is that there are neck injuries to both of those players, but they are both conscious. Evidently, Basil Boley did suffer an epileptic fit there. A few fears a little bit about a possible fractured skull as well. But just returning to Leeds, they have skill this season, and they have terrific camaraderie, which you were mentioning to me earlier on.
Yeah, they worked very hard, and Howard, in actual fact, on that interview, did state that for 30 minutes after Leeds scored their first goal, they were put under immense pressure. But as a unit, they stuck together and worked very, very hard for each other, and they're going to be tough to beat.
Yes. And Yeboah, I mean, as long as they have Yeboah around, Ray, I mean, they are capable of beating anybody, aren't they?
Well, they are. When he shows goal-scoring ability like that, he's going to frighten any defence.
Mm. I have to remind you that you're playing them. Queen's Park Rangers are playing Leeds at this weekend.
I'm looking forward to it. It should be a very pleasant afternoon.
Okay, thanks, Ray.